About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening. Welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And this evening, before we begin the program, I do want to present BCTV with this check or these checks from the Berks County Dog Training Club in the amount of $200 and another check from the Berks County Kennel Club for $1,000. We support BCTV and we hope you do too. Now this evening, since it's going to be hunting season soon, we have hunting dogs. Unfortunately, the Brittany's are the only ones that are here right now. The German Shorthair Pointers are still stuck on the bypass waiting for an accident to break up. So they'll be a little bit later. So we will talk to Terri, what am I talking about? Isn't that awful? I don't know where I came up with Judy. Even my other guest's name isn't Judy. Anyhow, Terri Hilliard, and she brought her Brittany's. So we're going to be talking about that breed first, and then we'll go on with the German Shorthair Pointers, which is our second breed. Now, suppose you tell us what a Brittany is, where it came from.
The Brittany's came from the northern part of France. They were bred for the on-foot hunter that would hunt any type of upland game bird, which would be quail, pheasants, partridge, woodcock, grouse. That's the primary birds that they do hunt.
They don't hunt rabbits then?
No rabbits.
No.
These are pointing dogs.
Okay.
In other words, they go in
on
find their game and they point it until the hunter comes and flushes the bird and then shoots the bird and then the dog will go retrieve.
Oh, okay. Okay.
There is also part of the sporting breed are flushing dogs, which go in and flush the game for the hunter and then they go and shoot the bird and the dogs will retrieve. So these are pointing breeds.
Okay. So then they don't flush. They just point.
They
point. It's your responsibility to actually shoot the bird.
Correct.
Did they come from the name Brittany? Is that just meaning French or does that mean?
It came from the Breton area of northern France.
Okay. What do they hunt now? I mean, none of those things are here any longer.
Well,
I mean, they stock, I guess, Blue Marsh and probably some state game lands with the pheasant.
Correct.
But what about the other things?
Well, we still do have wild grouse and woodcock in our area.
Really? Mm-hmm.
And we are in the migratory pattern of the grouse and woodcock. Some years it's better than others. I just had them up on the game lands on Sunday and they found two birds for me.
Wow.
Obviously we weren't hunting, but we were just out for a nice run, but they did find two birds for me. So.
Very good. And somebody on one of the radio programs said they were coming down the road and they saw a pheasant and they hadn't seen one for 40 years or something like that. And it's really, you know, it's really bad because there's no place, there's no habitat left.
No. A lot of the farmers have taken up those tree lines and stuff in their fields, so there's nowhere for them to hibernate over the winter.
Right. Oh, that's a shame. So what actually, since they're not, they really don't have very much to hunt any longer, what else are these dogs used for? What do you do with them? Obedience?
It's a very, very versatile breed. Not only can you do the field work with them, but these guys are show champions as well.
Mm-hmm.
They do work the field. We have done some obedience rally with them. There's quite a few Brittany's in the agility world out there.
Okay.
And they're wonderful dogs for therapy dogs.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Yeah, I'm partial to the Brittany's. I've never owned one. I just think they have such a wonderful personality. They just seem so sweet.
They are. They are very sweet. Wonderful house pets. Great with kids.
And they don't really, grooming's not, doesn't seem to be
a
big
problem. It's not a major issue.
They have a silky coat though, don't they? Their coat's not harsh like.
It's not supposed to be silky.
It's not supposed to be silky.
It's supposed to be, it can be soft.
Uh-huh.
It can have a little bit of curl to it, but it's not supposed to have the silky, like the silky terriers the terriers like
right,
that.
Right.
It's supposed to have a serviceable coat.
Do they have an undercoat?
Yes, they're double coated.
Okay. It's just that they don't seem to get knotted.
Mm-hmm. No, no.
Right, and that's what I mean by silky. You know, some of the dogs, it's like, oh, what do we do with this? But these guys just seem to have those nice little feathers. And what colors do they come in?
They come in orange and white.
Mm-hmm. Which this is orange.
This is orange and white. Liver and white.
Okay.
Which is dark brown.
Uh-huh.
Then they come in a roan pattern, which is a lot of like the spots on the nose here.
Okay, okay.
Throughout the whole body.
Oh, okay. Almost like the English Cocker Spaniel. That type of roaning, or
it would look more to somebody that wouldn't know roan, more like the German Shorthair Pointer, like
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then they also come in a tricolor, which is the liver and white with the orange markings.
Really? Now, where would they have the orange mark? Oh, is it specific, like looking on a Doberman?
It is.
It would be classic markings, which would be above the on the eyebrows, inside the ears, under the tail.
Huh, how about that? I don't think I've ever seen one of those.
They're not real common.
No, well, even the liver and white aren't very common, and I think they're very, very attractive.
Mm-hmm.
I guess the judges aren't as fond of them.
Well, I think they're starting to see more and more livers
now.
So they are, it's not as hard to finish a liver in the show ring as it used to be.
Because I saw my first one, it must have been 20 years ago, and I thought, oh, wow, is that gorgeous?
The
lady I was talking to said, yeah, and she's very hard to finish.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, what a shame, because she was just stunning. But they're this color, what, to blend in with the grass, or?
It's just been the most common color for the Brittany since they came over to the United States.
When did they come over? How long have they been here? They've been recognized for a long time here.
Right, about 1935.
Wow, wow. Why did they drop the Spaniel? They used to be called Brittany Spaniels, and now they're just called Brittany. Is it just to shorten the name, or?
No, because a Spaniel is a flushing dog, and these are pointing dogs.
Okay.
So that's why the Spaniel was dropped in 1985.
That makes a lot of sense. Now, are they easy to train, or do they have their own agenda?
No, they're very easy to train.
Okay.
They learn the hard things the bad things just as quickly as they learn the good things. But
as a
rule, they are very smart and very easy to train.
Good, good. So I would assume that because it is a hunting dog, you would definitely need a fenced yard?
I do not have a fenced yard, and I have seven Brittanys.
Wow, and they just stay around? They don't.
Well, you teach them as puppies, you know, their limits, their borders in the yard, and they're pretty good.
Wow, that's great. That's very good.
Because once in a while, you'll get a wander, but for the most part, they stay.
That's wonderful. Yeah, I my breed is a herding breed, and I have everything fenced, but maybe I'm a little overly cautious, but who knows. What health problems do they have?
Just mainly the common health problems of
just dysplasia.
Some.
Mm-hmm. PRA.
No.
No. Okay.
No. Seizures.
Epilepsy?
We have some epilepsy in some of the lines of the dogs.
Oh wow!
But as a rule, they are a very healthy breed. Mm-hmm. You know, my guys are hardly ever sick.
Wonderful, wonderful. Do the males? How much? He's a male?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. So then he's not really very much bigger than she is.
No.
So
they go between 35 and 40 pounds.
Okay.
As a rule. The males are usually closer to the 40 pound. Uh-huh. The girls are usually closer to the 35. So.
This is not a barky dog?
No.
No.
So apartment people, older couples would?
They do need their exercise.
Okay.
So apartment living, as long as, you know, you are dedicated to walking the dog and getting exercise, they would be fine. But otherwise, you know, they do need to be exercised.
Yeah.
They are a sporting breed, and any sporting breed is going to need, you know, their amount of exercise
every dog needs exercise, no matter what it is. I mean, so you have the little toys, and they got their exercise, but it's running around the house.
Mm-hmm.
But people will buy a lab and say, well, you know, we walk around the block and the dog's really hyper. It's like, whoa, yeah. I wonder why. So these dogs actually were bred then just as hunting dogs.
Correct.
For nothing else other than hunting dogs.
Correct.
Okay. How popular are they?
I haven't really seen the list lately as to where they come, but in the sporting breed, I think the last time they looked, they were like 8th or 10th on the list of sporting breeds.
You don't usually see them, you know, like walking down the street or, you know, it's not a very common
And we like it that way.
Yeah.
I don't want them to be too overpopulated.
Right, because then you get into a lot of medical problems.
Sure.
Why did you select this breed?
Well, we had Cocker Spaniels before.
Okay.
And my husband had a field Brittany.
Okay.
And when my last Cocker died, I decided that we were done. We weren't having any more dogs. And then I realized how much I missed it when I came home from work at night. So I decided that I might as well join my husband. And we'll have one breed. So we bought a Brittany, and that was 32 years ago, and we just keep adding to our numbers.
The start of something good, right? Well, we're going to take a break right now, and maybe by that time our second guest will arrive, but we're going to take a break, so stay tuned. We'll be right back.
You're watching All About Dogs on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other stories about animals and pets, go to www.bctv.org. All About Dogs is underwritten by the Berks County Kennel Club and by Berks Dog Training Club. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
We're back, and what timing! Our other guests did arrive, but we'll let them settle in for a couple of seconds, but because I'm still not finished talking to the Brittany people. What thing about the Brittanys would you change as a breed if you could?
Wow.
They've got to have something that you'd say, oh, if only.
If only.
You can't tell me this is the perfect breed. Come on.
Well,
just about.
There is not much I would change because they are the perfect size. And they do have a great temperament.
Unless you want a watchdog, then you don't have
don't
a good
want a
dog.
Right. If you
right.
Want a
That's
watchdog.
Exactly right.
You're
a
protective
watchdog.
Breed because
right.
they're not going to be your protective breed.
They love everyone.
Yeah.
And this. The girl here is what? What did you say?
She's 11, almost 11.
Almost 11 years old. And look at the great shape she's in. I think what's nice about the dogs that are white, you can't see the gray hairs, just, you know, the white hairs. They never look as old as they really are. But, yeah, it's a really nice. I like the Brittanys. So now we'll talk to our German short hair people. That was quite a trek.
It was fun.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Said facetiously? Was it really?
Yeah.
Oh my word. Yeah, I know both sides were just a mess, an absolute mess. And I'm thinking, oh my goodness, they're never going to get here.
That's what we thought too. Yeah.
These are German short hair pointers. And they come in what colors?
Well, this is liver and white.
Okay.
And we call it ticked. They also come in solid liver.
Okay.
Your perfect chocolate dog.
Uh-huh.
And there are black and whites.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And they can be any combination of liver and white. You'll see very white and very dark.
Okay. Now, this is the Roning that you were talking about in the Brittany's.
Well, yeah, it's similar to that.
Right, right. And this is the liver color. So now you can see the liver and you can see the orange. So, you know, and you all know what black and white is. Now, these dogs came from, obviously, Germany, since they're German short hair pointers.
That's true.
What other kind of pointers do they have besides short? Why are they called German short hair pointers?
They were bred with English pointers.
Okay.
They've got a little bit of bloodhound in them.
Oh!
For the nose.
Okay.
What else is in them, Lynn?
Looks like for the ears, too.
The basic is the Spanish pointer.
Which yeah.
no longer exists.
Oh!
But it's the base dog that they used.
Huh!
On the German short hair. They have poodle in for intelligence.
Wow.
They have
the bloodhound. Well, the poodle's a hunting dog, too,
yeah.
you know.
Yes.
Right. And for also intelligence. In
uh-huh,
too.
Uh-huh.
And then the other base dog would be your bloodhound.
Okay.
You know, wow. for the scenting conditions.
Yeah.
There's also a retriever in them.
Okay, so is this a new breed, so to speak, since there's such a combination, or does this go back many, many years ago?
It's relative. Ouch.
They have
good teeth.
Yeah.
relatively young breed.
Okay.
Late 1800s is when the base stock was
uh-huh,
bred.
Uh-huh. So what did they breed? What are they supposed to do?
They're supposed to be a versatile gun dog.
Okay.
To hunt practically anything. Large game, small game. In the United States, we primarily use them for birds.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. We were just talking about birds, and they're not meeting very many of them.
No.
Left any longer. Now, these guys are pointers, too, so they would do the same thing the Brittany's do.
They
point the game, you flush it, shoot it, and then they go and get it.
Right.
So then they're fairly easy to train as well?
Yes. Yes and no. Okay. It depends on the individual dog. I do most of the training.
Everything's relative, huh?
Yeah. I do most of the training in the, you know, for our short hairs as well as... I also train for others too.
Okay.
And I've trained Brittany's, and I've trained German wire hairs, and I've trained setters and
but of course these are the smartest.
One of the easiest though, I feel, is the German short hair.
Okay.
Okay. But then there's individual dogs and you don't know what they're gonna do.
Okay.
You know, sometimes you get what we call knuckleheads.
Okay.
Which
they
are very
have
difficult.
Their own agenda. They're not
right.
knuckleheads. They just have
right.
their own agenda, and it's not yours.
Right.
Now, do you train mainly for hunting?
Well, actually, the hunt test program.
Okay.
This is Penny. She's a master hunter. That's
okay.
the top level
mm-hmm.
hunting dog. And she, Heidi here, is a senior hunter. Just finished her senior, and she's going to start her master
okay.
in the spring.
Okay. So what then they have, juniors, seniors, and masters?
Juniors, seniors, and masters.
Okay. And I'm assuming that each level goes up in difficulty?
Difficulty.
Okay.
And what they have to do.
Okay.
How
okay.
they have to perform.
Now, are any breeds qualified to go into these hunt tests, or do they have to be a hunting breed?
The way American Kennel Club has this set up, currently, they have flushing, you know, competition.
Uh-huh.
They have retrieving competition and pointing competition. They have, coursing competition.
Oh, okay.
And quite a lot of different things for different
uh-huh.
for different breeds, like with ourselves and the Brittany's, we're in the pointing
mm-hmm.
Part of it. They also have field trials, which are a little different than the hunting test program.
Okay. Okay.
I prefer the hunting test program because basically it's you're on foot, you're not on horseback,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
and the dogs are meant to be within shooting range,
okay,
at least 80% of the time. Where on field trails, they like to see them run big, mm-hmm, where you have to follow them on horseback just to keep them in sight sometimes.
Well, the reason I asked is because I know they have opened up lure coursing to all breeds.
Oh, they have?
And I just, I just wondered if they were thinking of doing the same thing with the hunting breeds.
Well, they're talking about possibly allowing pointing Labradors.
Oh!
In,
oh, that seems strange, doesn't it?
Yes, they have Labradors now that do point.
Huh.
And they're thinking about adding them or allowing them to come to our hunting test, you know, for the pointing dogs.
Wow, that's interesting. Now, do these guys have a double coat as well?
No.
Okay, they're single coated. Okay. Grooming is not a problem, or are they similar to the Dalmatians and they shed their hairs all over the place? Okay.
And we call them wash and wear.
Okay, wash and wear. Okay, all right. But they do shed, so you would have to have lots of tweed.
It's recommended, yes. Black is not a good color around these guys.
Black is not a good color, right. exercise. I would assume these guys need lots of exercise, like the Brits.
Yes, okay. Definitely a high-energy dog.
Okay. Fenced yard?
I recommend it.
Absolutely.
Although I know people without it,
mm-hmm,
and they handle it good.
Well, she has 7 and no fenced yard.
Wow.
I think that's amazing.
Yes.
We have 7 and a very fenced yard.
Would these be good dogs for an older couple, or how are they with kids?
Good with kids when they're raised with them.
Okay.
The same with cats. They can be raised with cats.
Mm-hmm.
We don't recommend an adult go into a cat home.
Okay.
But a puppy, yes.
Okay.
My guys are not raised with kids. But the puppies that go out with kids do very, very well.
Oh, good.
Not necessarily an older person's dog, unless they're high energy, too.
All right. Okay. So they're too active for an older person. What do you make a good apartment dog?
No.
No. Okay.
No. All not right. Unless you're very dedicated.
Okay. They're not barkers, though.
Yes.
They are barkers. Oh. Yes. Oh. Okay. I wouldn't expect that.
This is my champion barker.
Oh. Thank you very much. What kind of health problems do they have?
I would say overall they're a very healthy breed.
Okay.
There are odd things, but mm-hmm, nothing that is substantially common.
Okay.
We do health tests.
Right.
To try and improve that.
Okay. Hip problems?
It's minimal now.
Okay. Eye?
Very little.
Really? Okay. Anything else? Odd?
Odd? There's a couple odd diseases out there that are so rare.
Mm-hmm.
We do have tests for them.
Okay.
But they're extremely rare. A day blindness is one.
Oh.
Cone degeneration, where the dog can't see in bright light, but fine in the dark.
Wow.
And there's an ugly, ugly skin disorder that has cropped up primarily in the field trial dogs.
Oh, okay. Now, they look similar. It's not like the setters, where you have a field trial dog that looks totally different than a show dog.
A lot of our field trial dogs do not look like our show dogs.
Really?
They look like they were crossbred with whippets.
Oh, my word.
Come on, honey.
Jeez, I thought, this was a dual breed like these guys.
It is,
uh-huh,
but there is a field trial contingent which has gone off on its own little way.
Oh, wow.
And when we see them in the magazines, we laugh.
Yeah, that's a shame.
It is.
Because if the dog was bred to do the job, you shouldn't have to improve on the dog is. Because I know with the setters, and I guess some of it is understandable with the coat, but, with these guys, they don't have a coat.
Right.
Now, you said they come in black. That's not a recognized color here, though, is it?
It is recognized for everything but the confirmation ring.
Oh, okay.
Our parent club has yet to approve them being shown.
Oh, nice.
But you'll see them in obedience and all the field events.
Hello, sweetheart.
Agility.
Mm-hmm.
And they look just like this, but it's black and white.
Now, where would that have, is that from?
Well, that's from Germany.
They didn't care?
They cared in that they concentrated on this color.
Okay.
However, the black and white is still out there.
Okay.
We can breed to a black and white and uh-huh. register the dogs.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Your chances in the litter are very odd. You never okay. know what you're going to get. I know yeah. people that bred a liver and white ticked girl mm-hmm. to a black and white male,
mm-hmm.
and the entire litter was black and white.
Oh, my word.
15 puppies.
Oh, my God. 15 black and white puppies.
Scary.
Yes, yes. But she must have been very strong in the black and white, you know, the girl.
She probably had it back in her pedigree
sure. somewhere.
Sure. Wow. Especially if she had some old German back there.
Yeah. But I would think it would darken the liver color as well.
It you does.
Know, makes a nice dark liver color. What about this breed would you change? If you could change anything about this breed, what would it be?
Do you change?
Don't tell me it's a perfect breed like the Brittany's.
No, it's not.
They couldn't think of anything. And I said it would make a lousy watchdog. Yeah.
Well, the weakness in this is, in the field, is their retrieving. Their retrieving is not as strong as I would like
okay.
to see it.
Okay.
But they were originally bred for pointing.
Yes.
Not
yes.
for retrieving.
Yes.
They put the retrieve there mm-hmm. as an additional.
An extra incentive.
Incentive.
Get the dog, yeah.
Right.
Well, thank you very much. I'm glad you were able to make it. I guess that's our program for this evening. So if you are interested in either one of these breeds, please call the Kennel Club. Both breeds, you know, if you're going to a reputable breeder, they have done all the genetic testing, and you are going to get a healthy, stable dog from a reputable breeder. So if you're interested in either breed, call the Berks County Kennel Club, and we will put you in touch with some reputable breeders in the area. So for this evening, good night.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.